Good afternoon, everyone. Sorry for morning session. Due to some technical issues, we are not able to come online. So we'll start the same topic, that is Pindus Veda. So before we start with the prayer, Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat, Mishri Guruve Namaha. Om Shanti Shanti. So Pindus Veda. So as I told in an earlier session, Pindus Veda means the Pindarupa Svedaha. That is Pindus Veda. It's a type of a Sankara Sveda. We can classify it under the Niragni Sveda and Sagni Sveda. In that, the Sagni Sveda, that is the Sagni Sveda, that is it is the one type of a Sankara Sveda. We can correlate with this one. So coming to the Pindus Veda, why it is named as Pinda? Because the Svedana material which we are using, we are making it is in a pinda form. That's what we are using this for the Svedana purpose. So that's what the name is suggested. It is a pindaha. So pinda Sveda. So coming to the possible grading of a pinda Sveda. So how the grading is there? So how we can correlate with the gradings? So when you are categorizing or when you are studying the Sankara Sveda, we can classify into three types like Snigdha Sveda, Ruksha Sveda, and Snigdha Ruksha Sveda. Both we can consider here because of the Snigdha Sveda means the properties for the Pinda Sveda, the drugs which we are using, that having the predominant of Snigdha Guna. So that's what it is considered as Snigdha Pinda Sveda. So when we are considering for a Ruksha Sveda, the properties of the Pinda Sveda are mainly having the Ruksha Guna. And Snigdha Ruksha Sveda means they having the both, like Snigdha Guna also and Ruksha Guna also. For example, if the grading is like this, so we are performing some studies of thesis studies, that is 0 to plus 1, like this category, you can see in the slides. So one more thing is minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, like that. So these gradings will applicate on the particular how we can adopt the particular type of the Sveda in the which conditions, like in which condition we can adopt the Snigdha Sveda and which condition we can adopt the Ruksha Sveda. So, and when which condition we can adopt Snigdha Ruksha Sveda. So, just remember when the patient comes to with you, Kapha Varana is there more. In that condition, we can start with the Valluka Sveda. Like example, Amavata patient comes, if it is a Gambhira Vata, Vedana is the more, Stambha is there, it is a more of a Shota, etc. In that conditions, we can start our treatment with the Ruksha Pinda Sveda. First, we can start with initially Valluka Sveda. Next, we can start the Valluka Sveda when the Samalakshanas get disappear, when the Niramalakshanas appear mildly, that time we can adopt these kinds like Snigdha Ruksha Sveda, like we can use the Patra Pinda Sveda, Jambhira, Churna or Chinchalavana Pinda Sveda, depending upon the symptoms. That only says in Ayurveda, depending upon the Rogi Bala and Roga Bala. So before performing any of the Panchakarma, we should aware about the Sama and Niramalakshana of the particular disease. So when the Samalakshana is there, we cannot directly go for Snigdha Sveda, just remember. And when the Niramalakshana is there, you can go for directly Snigdha Ruksha or Snigdha Sveda. Nirama is there. If it is a Samalakshana, then we can only do the Svedana, which is the Ama is there means Ruksha, Nirama is there means Snigdha or Snigdha Ruksha Sveda we can adopt. So this type of we can modify. So depending upon which is available source in our outside, we can take it and depending upon that, we can do the Svedana. So these are the possible grading we can calculate like 0 to 4 and 0 to minus 1, 0 to minus 4 and 0 to 4. And after that means it's a grading like that means because Snigdha is the mild, we can consider it is moderate and it is severe. Is when the Lakshanas, when you want extreme heat, you can adopt the Ruksha Sveda. When you want in between, like that, we can adopt the Snigdha Ruksha. When we can adopt the minimal temperature or some other temperature, so that time we can adopt the Snigdha Pinda Sveda. So coming to commonly practiced Pindus Vedas in their day-to-day practice. So like Valuka Sveda, Patra Pindus Veda, Jambira Pindus Veda, Shashtika Shali Pindus Veda, Masha Pindus Veda, Churna Pindus Veda, we are adopting like these type of Pindus Veda, Svedas in our day-to-day practice. So first Valuka Sveda. So Valuka, Valuka means here we have to take the sand. The sand which is divided of stones or thorns, etc. We should clean it. So after cleaning the sand, we should take in one normal pan, just roast it. And after that, we have to take a cotton cloth, and just in that cotton cloth, we have to put that the valuka, and we have to tie, and we have to apply on the patient's body. So when we have to apply in the severe conditions, like it's a one type of the Ruksha Pindus Veda, when the extreme condition, so when the kapha avruta is there, when the kapha adhikya is there, stabdata is there, that time we can adopt the valuka sveda. And urustamba and some of the medogata roga, granti and kapha medavruta vata. In this type of a condition, we can adopt the valuka sveda. So coming to the possible modification. If the valuka is not available, because recent days the valuka, the sand mafia is more. So because of some restrictions of the government, the sand is not available. That time, what we can do? How we can modify the treatment? So we can use the prani purusha. So we can consider it a prani purusha, means the cow dung or horse dung. We can use that. We can consider a Karisha Pindus Veda also. Or prani purusha we can use in the place of the particular the sand. So we can, otherwise we can use lavana also, and we can use ishtika churna, normal ishtika churna we can use, or some of the vatahara patras if it is not there, means more of vatahara patras or vatahara churnas, or in that only, in the sand only, we can add some of vatahara patras or vatahara churnas also. And we can adopt, because the valuka sveda considered it as more of rukshatama. So and it is, when it is a rukshatama, so if a patient body is not tolerating, so we can apply the oil to particular patient's body depending upon the conditions. Like we can use nimba taila also, bratsaindavadi taila, kottam chukkadi taila. After application, we can perform the particular valuka potali sveda. So these kind of modifications we can perform. So we can add with sand also, means sand plus lavan also, or ishtika churna plus sand also. Otherwise, we can add up some patras to that also. We can modify. So when we can modify, that time only we can appreciate the results. Otherwise, we cannot appreciate the particular results. So coming to the Patra Pindus Veda. So one is Ruksha is over. Now is Snigdha Ruksha Sveda. So it is both having, the both gunas it is having. So example, for my practice, I am using the Shigru, Arka, Dattura, Agnimanta, Chincha, Eranda, Nirgundi Patra. So these kind of leaves I am using for the preparation of Patra Pindus Veda, and some of the Vatahara Dravyas like Vacha, Shatapushpa, Devadaru, Rasna, we are using for the purpose of the Patra Pindus Veda. So like Saindava. So Saindava we are using, Thaila using, we are using the lemon and grated coconut. So it's some they are not using the lemon and grated coconut, simply they are using with the Patra Pindus Veda. Simply they are using the patras for the Pindus Veda. So just it's depending upon their yuktis and their modified treatment protocol. So when we are using this one, how we are preparing, just I will give the example. So we have to take a lemons. So they are 60 numbers. We have to cut it into small pieces, and we have to add and grated coconut. We have to grate the coconut firmly. After grating that coconut, first we have to take a pan. In that pan, we have to add oil, that is taila. And after that, we have to add the coconut, grated coconut and lemon. So start a frying. Means when we have to stop that frying, means the till orange color. So till orange or a little bit brownish color, till that time we have to fry. After frying, we have to add the patras. How we have to add the patras in the manner, the thicker leaves are first we have to use. Like the Arka having the thicker leaves, Agnimanta or the Tura, whichever the leaves having the thicker, we are adding the first. We are not adding directly leaves here, just we are chopping the leaves in a smaller proportion, just we are cutting in a smaller pieces. After that, we are adding the particular, the patras in that. So the patras we have to add that by. First is thicker, after that thinner. Like that we have to add. After that we are adding the lavana to it, that is Saindava lavana. And after that we are adding the vacha, shatapushpa, rasna, devadaru, etc. Depending upon the vatahara dravyas we are using. So after that frying completely, after that mixing, just we are taking in the particular vastra and we are making it potli and we are using for the purpose of the Svedana karma. So Svedana karma, the patrapinda sveda, where we are applying. So when the patrapinda sveda applying, for example, if a patient comes with grudrasi, so when the radiating type of a pain is there, so radiating pain is there, some type of a shota is there. So the radiating pain, the shota is there, means the both guna having vata also and kapha also. So both is there, radiating also is there, shota is there, means little bit amount of kapha is also there. In that type of a condition, we can adopt the patrapinda sveda, because here our treatment choice is snigdha ruksha sveda. So snigdha ruksha means the combination of both. We can use in this type of a sveda, or we can use in a sandigata vata or amavata where the little bit of amalakshanas when suppressed, that is samalakshana suppressed, some amount of means like lagavata in the patient, means because when the samalakshana is there, gauravata will be there. So that gauravata when reduced, we can adopt the patrapinda sveda in the amavata condition also. Or otherwise, the mainly the amavata is mainly affecting the joints, like some type of stiffness is there in a joint, that time also we can adopt the patrapinda sveda. So some possible modification. So example, here I have shown so many the leaves like Shigru, Arka, Dattura, Agnimanta, Chinchar, Eranda, Nirgundi Patra, etc. If I think everyone having one doubt that in my place, we don't have any of the other patras also, whichever mentioned, how can we practice? So just remember, whichever the patras available, you can take that only in that amount. Like example, if it is a Nirgundi is abundantly available, you can collect the Nirgundi and you can make it as a potali and you can use for the Pindasveda purpose. Like that, whichever the available patras we have to, whichever the available in your surroundings, depending upon that, you can make a Pindasveda. That is Patra Pindasveda. So simple, remember, what is the Patra Pindasveda? We cannot go, if classically told, if these patras are not available, means how can we can perform? It's wrong thing. Just you have to use your yukti. And depending upon that, Vatahara. So here you are treating the Vatahara, then you can use the Vatahara patras. So depending upon your yukti, you can choose and you can adopt that patras for the preparation of Patra Pindasveda. And we can use the different churnas also. So example, we are using rasna, shatapushpa or more. So you can use other also, like you can use ashwagandha also sometimes. It's depending upon the need. And we can use yagyok also. So it's all depending upon our yukti, we can modify the treatment. The principle is the same. Just we are using the different patras or a different combination of a churnas, depending upon the rasaguna virya vipaka of the particular substance and depending upon the roga. Depending upon that, we can do the modifications. Next is the Ruksha Patra Pindasveda. So how the Ruksha Patra Pindasveda? So that is the Snigdha Patra Pindasveda, because we are using the oil and grated coconut, lemon and oxalate. This is the Ruksha Patra Pindasveda. So how the Ruksha Patra Pindasveda we can modify, how we can perform, means Eranda Patra we have to take, and Dattura Patra, Nirgundi Patra and stone and cloth. The stone, which is slimy in nature, which is available the seaside or the riverside. I am using for the purpose of the Svedana, that kind of the stone. The stone has to be big, with our one palm measure, it has to be there. Or we can use 2 to 3. If it is 2 to 3, if you are using, means it's difficult to perform also and difficult to heat also. If it is a stone is in a bigger size, means we can easily, we can perform the particular procedure. So how the Ruksha Patra Pindasveda will perform? means we are using that stone and we are keeping that stone on the fire. So when the stone will directly heated, and in one more side on the vastra, we are keeping the Eranda Patra, the Dattura Patra and Nirgundi Patra. Above that, the heated stone we are keeping and we are making it potli, and we can start the doing the Svedana. This is considered as Ruksha Patra Pinda Sveda. Why we are using this kind means when we cannot use directly stone for the purpose of a Pinda Sveda. When if we will use, now what happened means the temperature will be risen in that particular stone, it will cause the burning. So because of to avoid the burning issues, so we are using with the purpose of the Vatahara Patras, because the Patras also having the some property of Vatahara action. If you are using or the media of the transformation of a heat through that Patra, means it will give a tremendous results comparatively with the other procedures. So that's what we are using, the transmission of a heat through the Patras. So when there is a Ruksha Patra Sveda, when we are using means when there is the more amount of Kapha Avrutta is there, when means the Gridrasi patient having the Kapha Adhikyata more, the Kapha predominant is more, or Kattigraha, in that condition the stiffness is more, in that type of a condition we are adopting these kind of the Patra Pinda Sveda. So next, coming to the Jambira Pinda Sveda. So Jambira Pinda Sveda, it is the Snigdha Ruksha Pinda Sveda. So normally how I am practicing means I am taking the lemons, because we are not it's not easily available the Jambira to everyone. So Jambira is in a big size, it's like we can call it as the orange shape, means orange, how the orange will be there, na? In that manner it will be there. That Jambira, it is not easily available, just we can replacing with the our lemon. So lemon we are using in a 25 in numbers. So we are using, and Lashuna 100 grams, and some of the Vatahara Dravyas, Saindava, Taila and Haridra. So we have to start firing with a pan, and in that we are adding little amount of the Taila, that is 100 ml we are using. And after that we are using the cutted lemons and the Lashuna. Lashuna here we are not using directly, the crushed Lashunas we are using for this purpose. So after that just we have to start frying. When the appearance of the color of that particular the lemon and the garlic coming to the little bit brownish color, or a light brownish color, or light yellowish color, complete yellowish color, that time we are adding the Saindava, Haridra and Vatahara Dravyas. And after completely frying, just we have to take in a potali or the cloth, and just we are making the potali. So this we can use the Jambira Pinda Sveda. So Jambira Pinda Sveda, where we can use means the pain, the rucha, the which is related with stamba. Mainly the stamba is there. If it is a stamba is there, and the restriction joint movements will be there, that time we can adopt these kind of a the Jambira Pinda Sveda. So some possible modifications. If the lemon is not available, we can use Madhifala also. If the Jambira is also not available, we can use a normal lemon also. And for the frying purpose, here we are using the oil, the Taila. Taila is also the Vata Haradravya, but we can use the Vasa and Majja. So Vasa and Majja also we can adopt in the particular in these combinations. So when we can adopt the things means Vasa and Majja, when the Vata dominant is there, so when the Vata dominant is there, so when if we are using the Vasa and Majja in the place of Taila, means it will give a strength to our body also. Example, the mainly the Pinda Svedas which we are performing, the Patra Pinda Svedas or Snigdha Ruksha Pinda Svedas, in mainly Asthi and Majjagata Vadis. So if we are using this kind of means, it will beneficial to the particular Asthi or Majjagata Ashraya Vyadhis. So that so it's depending upon the Vasa and Majja also, the properties of both are varies depending upon the animals. If we are using the Varaha Vasa or Varaha Majja, means it will having the Guru Guna more, so it will causes the Brahmana. So like that, we can compare with others depending upon the condition of the patient. We can use the different vasa and majja in the place of the oil. So next is the Shashtikashali Pindasveda. Shashtikashali Pindasveda, everyone is enthusiastically practicing in some of the spas also. Like whichever, it's not Ayurvedic spas also, they're practicing with the Shashtikashali Pindasveda or Parisheka with Dugdha and other things. Because of cleansing our body and beautiful making of our skin. So because of Saundaryakara, they're using this kind of a Shashtikashali Pindasveda. So normally how we are preparing means we are using the Rakthashali for the preparation of this one. That is the red rice and a Balamula Kwatachurna. And mainly Balamula Kwatachurna we are using for the Shashtikashali preparation. The Kshira, Balamula Kwata and Rakthashali for the preparation of this one. When the rice is prepared, the 1.5 liter of Balamula Kwata we are using and 1.5 liter of Kshira we are using for the preparation of the Rakthashali. In that, we have to boil. Means Balamula Kwata Kshira plus Rakthashali. We have to boil it and the prepared the rice. In that prepared the rice, we are using, and some people they are using Amlaki also in the this one. And before performing the Svedana, we should apply the Pichu over the head. To almost all the patients, we can use the rasna or some amount of a grutha. We can mix it with the anterior fontanelle. We can just apply, or we can use the pichu also in the pichu manner, like shiro pichu manner. We can use. So here, when the Shashtikashali Pindasveda we are using, the Shashtikashali Pindasveda when we are using means the kevala vata condition. The Kevala Vata, only the Vata is there. Nirama Lakshanas are there. No any Sama Lakshanas. In that condition, we can adopt these kind of a Svedana. So some of the possible modification. If we can add some type of a Masha. Because mainly the Shashtikashali Pindasveda, behind the motto is the giving the Brahmana. So the whichever the Brahmana causes, the items is there. Like we can use Masha also. Some type of grated coconut. Or we can use egg also. Or soya bean. Or tila, goduma, we can use. Just we have to soak previous night the masha, and next day we can use the masha. So if you are using with the masha plus rice, means we can call it as masha Shashtikashali Pindasveda. If you are using coconut also, it's depending upon the condition of the patient or a rogi, we can use these kind of the alternatives. So just remember, when the more brahmana is required, we can use egg also or soya bean also. So that should be soaked and that should be boiled. We can use these purposes, or goduma also we can use. So these are the possible modification we can adopt in the treatment aspect. We can use Mamsa Pindasveda. So it's some practitioners, they are practicing with the Mamsa Pindasveda. How they are practicing? The cow's milk and bala root and freshly prepared shali. And in that they are adding the particular Mamsa. And they are practicing for the purpose of the Pindasveda. Just see the method. The cleaned and cutted pieces of the bala root are boiled in the 10 liters of water, which is reduced to 2.7 liter. Take a 1.36 liter of a kashaya, and 250 ml of godugda, 450 grams of the boiled chalice, and add 450 grams of flesh goat milk or a pig or a hen. That the mamsa should be cut into pieces. Instead of bala decoction, only the mamsa, rasa we are using, and heat the entire, and the flesh should be cooked properly. Means that mamsa should be cooked properly. After cooking that, we have to use the potali. We have to make a potali. And take remaining the kashayas and the godugda, and just we have to dipping method we can use. We have to heat it in a continuously in other manner. In one pan, we can take one bowl. We can take that particular kashaya and the kshira, and the dipping method we can adopt in the patient. So these kind of means the Shashtikashali Pindasveda or Mamsa Pindasveda, which are causing the Brahmana. That is the mainly these are considered as Snigdha Pindasveda. When we are using means the Kevala Vata Vyadhi, like we can use in Pakshagata, or we can use in Ardita, or chronic osteoarthritis. If it is a chronic, if it is a delayed in that condition, whether the Sama Lakshanas are not there, Nirama Lakshanas is there, whether Vedana is more, in that condition, we can use. So benefits of this mamsa, this one is marasmus disease of the children's, the delayed milestones or muscle wasting or a poliomyelitis. In this condition, mainly the requirement is the tissue degeneration, means the tissue degeneration has to be performed, means the generation has to be performed, regeneration of the tissues for muscular wasting or a poliomyelitis or a marasmus of the children. So we are using these kind of things. So what happened if you are conducting in this Mamsa Pindas Veda or Shishika Shalaya Pindas, it tones up the tissues. It will increases the tonicity of our tissues and it will do the soothing effect to our nerve and it will help for the circulation increasing. So just remember, we can consider our Vata with the neurons, impulses of the neurons. So we cannot consider, because the Vata is the avyakta in the Swarupa. So whenever we are practicing the particular the things, the mode of action, we can understand in this way. When the neurons are there, so neurons impulses we can consider with the Vata. If we are using this one, the Snigdha Guna is opposite of Vata Guna. So Vata is more, means that Guna will be suppressed by these kind of the Pindas Vedas. It will helps for the increase in the circulation and it will strengthen that neurons and it will helps for the tissues also. So coming to the sum of the Churna Pindas Vedas, how we are using some other Churna Pindas Vedas, we are using in a types like dry method or a dry with Ruksha Taila method and a steam method and dipping method, Sarvanga and Ekanga. We are practicing with the dry method, means just we have to use like Valuka Sveda only. What happened? We are using here only the churna. Just after frying, just we are using in a potali and we are making for the Svedana purpose. And second is the dry with Ruksha Taila, means we have to use churna plus taila in that combination and we have to make a potali and we can apply for the Svedana. And another method is the steam method with the Dhanyamla or Kanji. So you have to prepare the potali and you have to put up like a Dola Yantra Svedana, how we are keeping the particular potali on that the Dola Yantra Svedana. Same that condition, if the Dhanyamla is there in one patra, means we have to use one stick and we have to tie the potali and we have to use the steam method. Because of steam, what happened? The Kashaya, Dhanyamla and everything will be gone the particular the pinda, and that pinda sveda we can use for the purpose of our svedana. Or one more thing is there, that is dipping method means here dhanyamla with steam method we are using, and another method means the in heated dhanyamla only we have to dip and we can apply on the patient's body. This is called as the dipping method. So it can be, means all these method can be, we can adopt in the sarvanga also, ekanga also, because it's a type of a sveda, sarvanga and ekanga sveda. Sarvanga means if a disease is more, means it if a disease is like Sandigata Vata, so it is affected to with the more joint, means we can go for Sarvanga Vata, Sarvanga Sveda. If it is only Eka, means only one part of the particular body, then we can go for the Ekanga Sveda. So how we are using, means it's a dry method. Just see first two pictures shows the dry method and one more method, that is the Churna Pindas Veda steam method. See the how the steam means below the in that below vessel containing the Dhanyamla and Kaji in that manner. And another is the dipping method. See the dipping method, in that we have to dip Dhanyamla, the hot Dhanyamla, in that we have to dip and we can apply. So these are the three methods we can perform in the patients. So next is the Churna Pindas Veda with Dhanyamla dipping. So how we are using, means depending upon the Sthanika, the Kola Kula Tadi Churna, we are using 50 grams. If it is for Sthanika, we are using the 50 grams is enough for to make for, because only one part, like one knee joint or one elbow joint, this is the requirement is there. We can use the 50 grams is enough. If it is Sarvanga, 200 grams. Kola Kula Tadi Churna, we are using, and Klita Churna and Dhanyamla, 1 liter is required for Sthanika. If it is for Sarvanga, we can use the 2 liters. So Dhanyamla or Kanji we can take it as, and some kora cloth we have to take, and we have to make the potali and we have to do the Svedana. So possible modifications, like if kolakolathadi churna is not available, means we can use kottam chukkadi churna or jadamayadi churna or different combinations or different churnas we can adopt. Like instead of dhanyamla, if it is dhanyamla is not available, means which we can use, like chincharasa, because amla guna is there main, and gomutra we can use, takra we can use, or some other kashayas also we can use. The whichever having the kashaya guna and amla rasa pradana dravyas are there, we can use for the instead of dhanyamla. So some klutadi churna. So klutadi churna pindasveda. If kluta is there, kluta masha. So how the klutadi means here, the materials we are using, this is klita, masha, tila, shatavaha seeds and methika seeds we are using in an equal quantity, and rasana, that is garlic, we are using, and bark of karanja and grated coconut. Like same, the preparation is same with like churna pinda sveda. First we are using the grated coconut, some amount of tile we are putting, and after that we are using the grated coconut and the bark of karanja, rasana we are using, and after that we are putting the all the churnas, and after frying we are making the potali and we are applying. So the duration of almost, if we are considering the standard operative procedures like SOPs by institutes, if your institutes or other CCIM or CCIRS website, you will get the particular SOPs. In that they have mentioned the duration of the swedana is that minimum 30 to 45 minutes. The half an hour is sufficient for the swedana you have to use. So benefits here, in kaphaja vyadhis or kasa or shwasa or pratishaya, swara bheda or kapha vata, means if it is a kapha vata jay is there, or only the vata, like facial paralysis and all those conditions. So we have to make the smaller potalis and we can use the for the swedana purpose. Next is the chinchalavana pinda sveda. So chinchalavana pinda sveda, actually when I am doing a post graduation, my colleague Dr. Annie, she performed on this thesis. We got a tremendous results by chinchalavana pinda sveda. So how we are performing means, mainly we are practiced with the chincha lavana pinda sveda in a gridrasi. The gridrasi which is having the kapha anubandha, means mainly the kapha vataja or vata kaphaja gridrasi, in that we are using. We are using here the chincha, saindava lavana, kottam chukkadi taila and dhanyamla. So first we have to use the chincha, which is the seedless. Means if the seeds are there, just we have to remove the seeds, and we have to use the chincha. And first we have to use the pan. In that pan, just we have to put the kottam chukkadi taila 50 ml. After that, we have to add the chincha. Just we have to start frying. After that, we have to add the lavana and start frying. And after that, we have to add a little bit of a dhanyamla, and just we have to boil it. And after boiling, just we have to take out, and just we have to make the potalis. And 1 liter of dhanyamla we can take, and the heated dhanyamla. In that dhanyamla dipping, just we can apply to the particular body. Means dipping method we are adopting here. So indication means katigraha and ama conditions, we can use the chincha lavana pinda sveda, because ama is there, more amount of ama is there. And one more thing, why we are using chincha, because our skin is mainly because of the pitta, because brajaka pitta is there. So if it is the lavana rasa is there, and other means the mainly the rasa which is nourishing to our skin, like amla rasa. So amla rasa, it will never cause any irritation to our skin. If we are using this kind of amla rasa pradana dravya, means it will helpful to our skin. And the chincha is also having effect on shulahara, vedanahara and vatahara also. So amla rasa is there, vatahara is also there. So in the ama condition, like if a patient comes with the ama vata, first we can go for the churna pinda sveda, or we can use chincha pinda sveda also. So kukkutanda pinda sveda, whenever the requirement of a brahmana, so when there is a requirement of a brahmana, that time we can use the kukkutanda pinda sveda. So just the yolk of egg we are using, the same, the lemon we have to use, cut into in small pieces, and just we have to start frying in a mild heat. After that, we are adding the little amount of oil and some powdered ducks. After powdered ducks, we are adding the egg yolk, the boiled egg, or the egg yolk we are using. means depending upon the condition, we can use egg yolk also or egg also we are using, and we have to mix it well, and after that we have to make a potali and we can use for the purpose of pindasweta. So in this type of a condition we can use these things. So the same type 2 with the egg and lemon kolakolata dichurna, the same nimbaditala we are using. The same, first we have to take a egg and we have to fry it, and after that lemon we have to add, and after that powder we have to add and fry well, and when the egg is mixed with completely, and we have to prepare the potali, and we can use for the 3 days. Almost all the pindasvedas like churna patra pindasveda, jambira pindasveda, or shashtikashali patra pinda, jambira pindasveda, or kukkutanda pindasveda, we can use up to 3 days. After 3 days we cannot use, just we have to discard it, and we can use another fresh pindasveda. Again we have to perform the fresh. So indication of this kukkutanda pindasveda in post polio residual paralysis, if a patient with this condition or a traumatic condition where the major trauma, that is asthi bhagna or other conditions like spinal myelopathy, in this condition we can use this kukkutanda pindasveda. Next is the kluta potali sveda. So just we are using the kluta, one part, and water, and in that we have to soak it, and after that when we are to start to frying, just we have to add the kluta and water, just we have to start boiling. After that we can add the vatahara churnas like shatapushpa, metika, and saidava. We have to prepare the potali and we can use, that is in arthritis or involuntary movement of or a contractions of the muscles, we can use the kluta potali sveta. Next is the bhusha or tusha pindasveda. So like our rice bran we can use here, and rasona, that is garlic, or shigrutvaka we can use in a small pieces, we can make it and we can use, and saindava 20 grams. The same, the bhusha is heated with the pan along with rasona, shigrutvaka and saindava, and divided into equal part, and we have to make it potali, and we can use. Where it is indicated means respiratory disorders, fever, or visuchika, in this condition we can adopt this bhusha pindasveda. Next is the karpas, means the cotton seeds, that is karpas bija also we can use, that is 500 grams, and the same we have to, karpas bija is heated, and after that we have to make a potali, and we have to use for the swedana purpose. The mainly indication is the vata pitta vyadhis we can use, or if the patient, because the karpas bija sveda is there, we can consider it as mrudu sveda, we can use for the sukumaras also. And karisha pinda sveda, like before only, like ruksha pinda sveda, in the place of the sand we can use the karisha or cow dung, I have told, na same here we also we can use the goat's dung and saindava, and some amount of leaves like tamarind leaves we can use. The same goat's dung and saindava is heated, and the tamarind leaves or juice is added in that when it is a boiling. When it is a little bit in a dry or a semi solid consistency, just we can take out, we can made a potli, and we can use. So how we can apply directly also with dhanyavali dipping method, or by ushma sveda, that is steam method also we can use. In the mainly the neurological disorders we can use this kind of a pindasveda. So other dravyas which we can use for the pindasvedas, example sweet potatoes we can use, laja we can use, or some navadhanyas, sarshapa seeds, or a maize seeds we can use for this purpose of pindasveda. So coming to the conclusion, the svedana means svedana, what the svedana is, stambha gaurava nigrahe. So mainly the svedana will do stambha nigraha gaurava nigraha. So that particular manner we are using, the adopting the svedana. The svedana is the one of the important treatment modality which is useful in the treatment of the disease in the form of purva karma also, pradhana karma also, and as well as paschat karma also. In some patients we are adopting the svedana as a purva karma, like for in a vamana and virechana, context on svedana purpose, we are adopting there as a purva karma, pradhana karma in other aspects, and paschat karma in other aspects, like that. So pindasveda is widely practiced svedana procedure where the treatment principle is based on the combined effect of the heat and the medicament. Means whichever the heat, the mainly heat, and whichever the medicament, like whichever the drugs or whichever the tailas or vatahara dravyas or whichever the dravyas, the properties plays a major role. So hence, the based on the roga and rogi, one can plan the different combination of a Pindus Vedas according to availability of the properties of the dravyas. So that's what I told you before. Whichever available in your surroundings, we have to use that kind of the dravyas for the preparation of the Pindus Veda. So just remember, when whenever you are practicing with the Pindus Veda, just we have to use these kind of the Pindus Veda depending upon the condition of the patient. Roga bala, rogi bala, it's must. So that's what, whenever you are trying with means whenever you are preparing the Pindus Veda, adapting with the Shashtika Shali with Masha means we have to use the Kevala Vata is there. That time only we can use the Masha or grated coconut. It's just we have to use the Yukti, or we can use this one, Palando also for Pindus Veda. We have to use the Palando. We have tried in a 2 to 3 patients with the Palando. So just Palando, that onion just we are frying after that onion, because the Palando is Vata Haradravya. So we are using for the Svedana purpose. In that manner, just we are adopting these kind of the Svedana. So if you have any questions, just you can mail me, or you can quote it in a comment box. So I will be able to answer for all your questions. So in next sessions also, we are dealing with the practical applicability, how we have to use our Panchakarma in our practical aspects. So that's what I chosen this Pindus Veda topic. So it is helpful for everyone, like practitioners also and students also. So that kind of, whenever we are practicing the particular Pindus Veda or whichever, so just remember Roga and Rogi Bala and Sama and Nirama Lakshana. So before adopting any such type of a treatment, just we can go through the particular the things like Sama Lakshanas of the disease, Nirama Lakshanas of the disease. Depending upon that only, we can choose the Snigdha Sveda or Snigdha Ruksha Sveda or Ruksha Sveda. So I thank to Tadvidya Sambhasha Parishad for giving me opportunity. In future, I think in next coming Sundays, we are dealing with another interesting practical oriented topics. So thank you on and all. Please stay tuned on the Tadvidya Sambhasha page for more details. You can mail me with your queries to drsurajpanchakarma@gmail.com also. Thank you on and all.